Hi, welcome back to GP Reactions. Hope you're well, hope you're having a great week. And as always, thank you for subscribing. So I'm going to be reacting to a track now by Odyssey, and it's called Native New Yorker. I believe it was taken from an album, self-titled album, Odyssey, and it kind of entered the UK Top 40 around about 24th of December 1977. So it was right there and climbing up the charts early in 1978. So and it kind of peaked at about number five. It's been a long time since I've kind of heard his song. It is a revisit and I'm kind of really looking forward to seeing this video. I think it's a studio performance, and it could be the German version of UK's Top of the Pops. So it's going to be interesting anyway. So without further ado, this is Odyssey with Native New Yorker. So to pause it, I just wanted to kind of say I love how kind of silky smooth their voices are, and I do kind of remember Odyssey from the 80s and the early 80s mainly, and I've kind of forgotten just how nice their voices sound together. Both singers are really, really good vocal wise. I like this video, it's very simple studio performance, but it's kind of delivered with so much charm. Really enjoying this video. I'd say how kind of impressive I'm finding the use of like the trumpets. It's very subtle, but and also the bass as well. I love it when kind of musical instruments are they're not overbearing, and they don't need their own sort of part of the song to express themselves, but collectively they kind of like really give a really kind of mellow feeling, but also quite excitable with the trumpets. And I guess this is China kind of like paints a picture of kind of New York with its kind of liveliness and its soul. And yeah, I'm really loving this. And a bit of sax. Thank you. Feels like a Broadway melody. So that was Odyssey with a native New Yorker, and I know there's pretty sure there's a longer version of this, and there's probably longer versions on the videos as well. What I kind of really liked about this song was that it was like a mellowness, which was through the vocals and the strings, and that was kind of contrasted with the sax, with the trumpets. And with the kind of bass, which kind of gave, it kind of felt like underneath the surface of New York and behind the hustle and bustle of the traffic and the busy crowds, kind of beats a soulful heart and, you know, people just wanting to get what everybody else in the world wants to get, you know, love, respect, you know, and... it's a really, really good record. I've never really kind of like thought about this record, and I remember this listening to this in those dark, damp days of 1978 January, and thinking how nice a sound it kind of was, and it didn't feel out of place. It's one of those evergreen kind of records. You can listen to it any time of year, and it kind of feels appropriate and correct. So yeah, I'm going to have a quick look at the lyrics now. Oh, and by the way, I really hope this doesn't get blocked. I've not had too much luck with these kind of soulful kind of records. I've had a few Gladys Knight ones fall by the wayside. So yeah, let's have a quick look at these lyrics. Running pretty New York City girl, 25, 35, hello baby New York City girl. I'm not really sure that what the 2535 is a reference to. perhaps it's a landmark in New York City, or maybe it's, I don't know, something else. But guys, if you know what that means, please tell me. You grew up riding the subways, running with people, up in Harlem, down in Broadway. You're no tramp, but you're no lady. Talking at street talk, you're the heart and soul of New York City. And love is just a passing word. It's the thought that you had in a taxi cab that you got left on a curb when he dropped you off at East 83rd. So again, I'm not really kind of sure exactly what that's referenced to. I'm assuming there's another landmark at East 83rd. But what I kind of like about this is that, so, you know, you're no tramp, but you're no lady. Talking at street talk, and it's kind of saying, you know, that's kind of your identity, and whether you like it or not, you're probably kind of stuck with that identity, and people may make assumptions about that identity and stereotypes. You're a native New Yorker, you should know the score by now. You're a native New Yorker, so music plays, everyone's dancing, closer and closer, making friends and finding lovers. You are lost in the shadows, searching for someone to set you free from New York City. And where did all those yesterdays go when you still believed you could really be like a Broadway show? You're a star, winning applause. You should know the score by now. This kind of sounds like somebody is kind of, they're kind of, their identity's already kind of been set, but they're kind of looking to break away from their identity and maybe kind of find somebody to, you know, kind of maybe meet someone who can take them out of New York City. I think sometimes we're a victim of our own environment, and, you know, we're kind of stereotyped perhaps by our accent or by our demeanor And unfortunately, it kind of limits what we kind of do in life and how far we can kind of get sometimes. I'm not sure so much these days, although I think how your demeanor would definitely kind of limit how far you kind of get. So yeah, I mean, and sometimes success is, there are some circles, social circles in life that, you know, will never accept you. I've known of cases where people who have actually won the lottery and they've won quite a few millions, and but then they've moved to a really exclusive neighborhood and they're still not accepted because it's not the money that makes them acceptable. The money is just a side product. They still are judged by their, how they sound, how they look, and how they behave. And even if we behave appropriately, the other two things come into play. So I know I love this song, and it kind of really gives you an atmosphere of New York, and it's such a beautiful sound as well. So yeah, let me know actually if there's a real kind of other story to this song, whether this was something that the two singers perhaps experienced. I believe they're a New York band. I might be wrong. Correct me if I'm wrong, please do. But yeah, join me in the comments below. Let me know what you think about his song and how you feel about his song. And if you've heard any Odyssey that isn't necessarily commercially popular, and I always love to kind of like dig beneath the surface with a few of these bands. So yeah, join me in the comments below. And till next time, take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and have a great week.